What's up, YouTubes?
Got Cord over here tuning. Building some kind of dragster.
We're just goofing around at the bike shop, playing RC trucks, playing mountain bikes, doing cool stuff. Got my Tamiya Knight Hauler, and I'm straight strapping on some drift meets just to have a fun and run her around. Going from Alcoa Dualies to some, I don't know, just some LA Common aluminum bags of crap. We're going to do some drifting. Peace. So predictions are third gear power slides is about all we're going to get out of it. But we'll see. I don't think anybody's tried this before. So even if the outcome sucks, we'll still post it. So nice. Pink shocks. I bought this truck to take it apart and use it as a donor for the axle and the rear set and the motor and the tranny, but the Tamiya crawler, or the Knight Hauler, sorry, is awesome. And then all the other semi trucks are just amazing. They're only $500 to get the kit started. So, I don't know. I haven't regretted 1 cent I put into this thing yet. So I'm still waiting. Dude, we're gonna be dragging mud flap.
It's gonna be low enough? Yeah.
Yeah, it's still be down there. It's gonna be nice.
Cord's building this Jeep dragster. Modifying some stuff so I can put his leaf springs on. Some crazy shit.
Productivity. So this is scientific, because I don't think anybody's tried to drift their semi truck yet. I tried with the dirt. We're gonna go for a slick floor, slick wheels.
You gonna put this thing in third?
Yep. Third gear launches, really. I mean, I don't even see a reason to drop to first or second, because I just slapped these on my TRX4 Shreddy Bear. And it was the most
anticlimactic thing I've ever seen. Man, this thing was really made me sad. I thought I was gonna do some sick donies, but
I can't even say it with my missing teeth. It was pathetic.
Well, plus you have Nick living with you now, right?
Yeah, which is pleasant. You know, it's teaching me a lot of stuff.
Make me smile.
You know, I don't like sharing a bathroom with a grown ass man, but what are you gonna do? You ready?
We got the meats on.
Yep, we got the LA Common slapped onto the back of the semi. I mean, not that these are much less slippery, but these in third gear busting traction, it should be pretty sick.
Yeah, these are like plastic. That's like actual rubber.
And these diffs are open. They're painfully open. There's no limited slip of any sort in them. So if the drift sucks, FYI, it's probably because the open diff, because your boy here knows how to get sideways a little bit. So.
You guys got your black Sharpie here?
Yes, sir. Happens to be a Milwaukee flavor. It's kind of like the Pepsi to the Coke, but I think it'll work. This is what they call a Dean's connector. It's a RC car world staple. Everyone uses them because they're high amperage, but they require two hands and everything else you have to disconnect and connect them, especially brand new ones. You pull on them so hard it's obscene. I'm waiting for that to change. It'd be cool if they're magnetic connections. Drop the battery in, it's like done. Hey,
so is the word getting out on these RCs?
Yeah, man, we're spreading the word. And we were just talking to someone from Five Star about making a listing for us. We're ready to pretty much ready to order parts, which is like, so is everybody at the internet. We're also ready to help you consult on which parts to get, what services to get.
Yeah.
See, grab third right off the bat. I think we're gonna have some fun.
Wow.
Okay. Alright, breaker, pulling the stool, man, hot on the mic. Grabbing third. Oh no. Oh, we lost a drive shaft immediately. What you got? You get to have these bigger jobs. what happened. Yep, up here at the tranny, maybe? He slid off. Okay.
Temporary tune break. We'll be back.
Whoever invented open differentials need to be, like, reviewed. I don't want to say doxed or anything like that, but, man, open diffs suck. You can't do anything, really. It's like, what's it good for? Parking lot scrub? Whoops. I meant, like a doctor says, he's like, there.
I think I might go get some pierogi.
Pierogi, dude, the sausages and the mashed potatoes. These little handles from Onyx Tools are amazing. Pretty much all you need for, like, pretty much to operate a full RC build or repair. Open diffs.
That's the ticket, my dog. See if you can come drift around the fight.
So you're taped to the back of the cab. It's got drift meats on it. Hopefully there's something to see. Yeah. I don't know. Drifting the rock crawler, drifting the semi truck. You're gonna have locked up axles. You can't have open diffs. It becomes very unpredictable. Okay. So while playing around with wheel swapping, I accidentally did something I fell in love with. Look at that. This thing looks like it's supposed to be like this. It's such a bad looking truck with the dualies all the way around. Old school 60s tractor pulling just bad mammy jammy. So then I'm thinking, why don't I slap on some bog rigs onto my bog rig? I mean, geez. All right, I'll get back at you. I gotta say, this blue truck on semi rims looks so good. It was like if Tonka made a super cool heavy truck, farm truck edition. Chrome on blue. Anyway, bogger swap on the semi is going great. So far, so good. I can't wait to see this thing. It'd be like a Mad Max machine. It's called the Knight Hauler. And now the front rims are super blasé, so we're trying to figure out how to get some boggers up front, too. Anyway, we'll get back at you. Come on, man. Can't get all boggered out on your semi truck, man. It's like, well, this thing gets stuck in the dirt so easily. I'm sick of it. What do you got here?
Have you looked in the red
room? Wow. I mean, what's on there? Meats? Veggies?
I don't know, man. I just saw fries and was like, I'm about it.
Can I get one of these things?
Yeah.
Maybe one of these normal ones here? Thanks, bro. Pierogies. Dude, they got sauerkraut in them. Yum. Kraut pierogi. Yeah, we're holding some veggies. So, the consensus on these boggers are totally awesome. And the trailer's kind of Arkansas looking, so it matches. Of course, the clockwork rig would look so dang silly that it'd be all bogger meats and flatbeds, but from here it looks awesome. And I'm sure now I won't get stuck on every little patch of gravel it encounters. If I saw this guy on the road, I'd give him 40 acres to turn around and leave me alone. Hey dog, cool on the stool, doing all the driving these days. Had to hire a driver. There's so many like fleet freights we had to do back and forth that, you know, dispatch is really getting under my nerves. What to do, Cord? Where's your truck at in the shop? Weird. Crazy. Looks like old, H Dog, cool on the stool, got himself into some kind of neighborhood of ghetto-ness. So he's trying to set himself free. Partial jackknife might be necessary. Get a shot of the pedals. Dang, I think the painted like nail polish is helping. Dude, you bogger means you could pop that curb. What happens when you got traction?
Cool.
Challenge extended. Trying to reverse the whole rig down the whole line of tires. Those bikes are lined up awfully open and straight.
Uh-oh. That cab's not making it.
All right, y'all. The gist. RC semi-trucks are a blast. Mountain bikes are a blast. Swapping wheels are a blast. Building a custom rig is super cool. There's no drawbacks. So, try to keep all your teeth, and I'll check you later. Peace.